Hey guys, it's Amy, Old Book New Look. Just wanted to make a quick video about what I'm packing. It is Sunday night. I'm going in tomorrow morning for my RNY gastric bypass. I'm wearing this because I wanted to show you guys. I got this, it's like a lightweight short sleeve bathrobe type of thing. It has snaps down the front. And I went and took it and I cut the sleeves down the seam, and then I sewed them, you know, kind of made them so they were nicer along the edges, sewed them up, and then I fastened snaps onto them. So if you look, I got snaps down my arms, so that the reason I did that was because when you're in the hospital and you've got IVs in your arms, you can't put, you know, you can't put your arm into the sleeves. So they have to be able to snap around you, like the hospital Johnnies do. So now I've got, you know, a nice, clean, comfy bathrobe that I can wear in the hospital while I'm walking around on the floor after surgery. And, you know, it's not necessary. You don't need to have one when you go in because you could always wear a Johnny one way and then a Johnny, like a Johnny front ways and then a Johnny back ways, so you cover both your front and your back. But it's just the comfort for me, so that's what I did. So let's take a look at what I'm bringing. I am overpacking a little bit because I know that I don't need all this stuff, but like I said, I mean, this is the size of the bag that I have, and it's not, you can see the scrub brush next, so it's not that big. It's a small travel bag. So it's not like it's going to be too cumbersome. My husband and my dad are coming with me, so one of them will carry the bag. But I got, you know, a scrub brush thingamajiggy. When I take a shower there, whenever I get to take a shower, I like to use that. Not necessary at all, but it's something that I like to use, so... I've got two sets of clothes, one for the way in and one for the, way out. You can definitely wear in what you're going to wear out, but I just really like having a nice fresh set of clothes for the way out, and it'll just make me feel more relaxed and more comfortable. And so, yeah, over here I've got my inhaler and my, photo ID, my insurance card, and my medication list, hair elastic, pen, and then this is my, like, my toiletries bag type of thing, and I'll show you what's in here. Female things, just in case. This is a bar of my own soap. This is conditioner. Shampoo's in here somewhere. Shampoo. Little travel size things. This is not a travel size thing, but I've had this in my house forever, so I figured I'd pack this too to go with the scrub brush. But nice smelly stuff, so I can feel nice and clean and smelling good once I'm in the, you know, ready to come home. My toothbrush is in here. Q-tips. This is another inhaler I use. I actually don't really use it. It's just preventative, and I don't actually even use it for that much. But they told me to bring it, so I am. Germex hand sanitizer, which they have at the hospital, but I'm bringing my own anyway. It's not very big. It's one of those travel size. Deodorant. What else do I have in here? This is a little travel mirror, like a camping mirror. I'm bringing that with me. It's very lightweight. It doesn't break. I always bring these with me. I don't know why. I never use them, but I guess they're good to have. I don't know. I think I kept that habit from when my daughter was young, and I used to keep those in the diaper bag just in case for spills or things I need to sticky clean up and stuff. So I always bring them. I don't know. It's an old habit. Okay. Travel size toothpaste. It's my pocket here. Chapstick. These I'm probably not going to use in the hospital, actually. I don't know why I'm packing these. I guess just in case. I have my toothbrush. I don't know. More hair elastics. Oh, hair clips and elastics and stuff. I'm not bringing any makeup. I don't really normally wear makeup anyway. And I certainly don't feel like I need it in the hospital. So the things here that I haven't packed yet that I'll need to pack in the morning are my hairbrush, my MP3 player, my husband's MP3 player, actually. I'm still loading some music up on it. I have some relaxation music that I'm putting on there. Let's see, what else? I think that's it. I don't know, I'm probably forgetting something, but I think that pretty much covers it. Yeah, it's tomorrow, guys. I weighed in today at 295, which is a 3 pound loss from last week. So, loss wasn't as dramatic as last week, but it's still a loss, so I'm down 35 pounds from my highest weight. So it's all good. My dad's here. He came up from Massachusetts. So he and my husband are going to be bringing me in tomorrow and staying with me in the hospital. I don't know. I plan on bringing my video camera with me, but not my computer, so I won't be uploading anything until after I get home. But I will have footage of my stay, and that's it. I think I'm gonna, I had one of my close friends came to visit me yesterday, and she took my my body shots for me on camera. So I'm gonna attach that to the end of this video. And that's it. Wish me luck. I know everything's gonna go great, and you guys will see me again soon. Love y'all. Bye. From the tops of the buildings to the streets below, between the Wall Street banks and the empty homes, between the lines of the people standing all in a row, there's a crack in the gutter where a flower grows. Reminding me that everything is possible. Yeah, reminding me that nothing is impossible. You gotta live for the one that you love, you know. You gotta love for the life that you live, you know. Singing hey, 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 no matter how life gets today, there's just one thing that I got to say. I won't let another moment slip away. Nobody ever tell you that it couldn't be done. Don't let nobody ever tell you that we couldn't be one. Don't let nobody ever tell you that it shouldn't be sung. Don't let nobody ever tell you you're the only one.